Hello my dear students, welcome to chemistry minutes. The question now appearing on your screen is exercise question 5.12. The question is, what is the difference between multimolecular and macromolecular colloids? Give one example of each. How are associated colloids different from these two types of colloids? So hamein multimolecular or macromolecular colloids mein difference batana hai uske example ke saath mein. और एसोसिएटेड कोलॉइड्स से इनमें क्या डिफरेंस है ये बताना. लेट्स राइट आंसर टू द क्वेश्चन. आंसर टू एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन 5.12. तो इन वन कॉलम वी राइट अबाउट मल्टी मॉलिक्यूलर colloids. And in the second column we will write about macromolecular colloids. So multimolecular colloids are formed by aggregation of small atoms or molecules. These colloids are formed by aggregation atoms or small molecules. Within the diameter of 1 nanometer, so diameter of molecules is within 1 nanometer, forming a particle. Having size within the range of colloidal particle. Size within the range of colloidal particle. And size of colloidal particle is between 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer. So 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer. Now the macromolecular colloids. So these colloids are by the substance having size of its molecule in the range of colloidal particle. Means the size of molecule will be between the size of colloidal particle, that is 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer. Now example of these colloids, example of multimolecular colloids is gold salt, sulfur salt, and example of macromolecular colloids is salts of starch, cellulose, nylon, now what is associated colloid? So multimolecular colloid is a colloid in which the atoms of small molecules aggregate to form a particle in the range of colloidal particle. And in macromolecular colloids, the particle of macromolecular solid is in the range of the size of colloidal particle. But in case of associated colloids, they behave as normal electrolyte at ordinary concentration or at lower concentration. But when the concentration is increased, their particles aggregate and form a particle in the range of colloidal size. So this type of colloids are formed by the substance which behaves as normal electrolyte at lower concentrations but at higher concentrations particles aggregate to form particles having size peptide size of colloidal fringe. So this will be the answer to the question.